Without any more chatter from me, let's invite Aaron and Adel present Garbage.
Please, a huge round of applause for Dan running the whole festival. Like you've been incredible. You've been incredible. Thank you for everything. Thank you for having us. We are Adel and Aaron present Garbage. And can we please get a suggestion of anything at all? I'm so sorry, over here. I heard acupuncture. Acupuncture? Great. We present acupuncture. Amber?
Mm-hmm.
Hey. Charles.
Hey.
Can I grab the seat?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so good to meet you.
It's so nice to meet you. It's very nice to meet you. Thank you for agreeing to dinner.
Mm-hmm. You look great, just like your pictures.
Oh, good, good. You look great as well.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I got hit by a car today. Are you laughing?
No, I'm just, holy shit, are you okay?
So good. Haven't really been to the hospital yet. I don't really want bad news, so.
Yeah. I'm the same way. I put it off. Yeah. I have a knee that should be, tomorrow.
I'll get to it.
Mm-hmm. I'm the same way.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Tanzillo, is that Italian?
Oh,
Amber,
yeah.
Tanzillo?
Yeah. I'm Italian, yeah.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. I thought this would be apropos.
Yeah, I like it. It's really sweet.
Good.
I've been trying to guess what date all these couples are on. Like first.
Oh,
date,
that's a fun
date,
game. Let's play that game. What is this? Like at 9 o'clock?
Mm-hmm.
Married.
Married?
Yeah, the guy's got a ring on. Right? Do you think married? Do you think he's stepping out? Mistress?
No. He looks too sleepy to have a mistress. you gotta have a lot of energy.
Yeah.
To have a mistress.
Yeah. I wasn't leaving. I was gonna see if you're all right.
So good.
Holy shit, are you all right?
Quick question.
Yeah.
Do I have arms?
You do, but there's not a lot of use of them right now. Yeah.
Like what you see?
I do like what I see.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yeah.
It said that you just moved to the city. How do you like it?
So far, so good. I mean, Milwaukee's great for, I'm a school teacher, history teacher.
Oh, sweet.
I'm a history teacher.
What?
It's a history teacher joke.
No, walk me through it. Walk me through it.
You know, they always say, my dad always said, if you have to explain a joke, it's not funny. history repeats itself.
Oh. Yes. That's okay, you said it twice.
I said it twice. Don't.
That's my tooth.
Your arm's going, well, it's good and bad.
You win some, lose a tooth, win an arm.
Yeah. Well, put that, let me get you some milk.
No, I'll put it in my wine.
Did that warrant a wink?
I don't know. Am I winking? what grade do you teach?
I teach high school. Mm-hmm.
Ooh, which grade? All of them?
Yeah, everybody takes history. Did you go to high school?
I did.
Okay.
I did.
Did you not have history all 4 years?
I did, but I had a different teacher all 4 years. You must teach at a small school.
It's a small school.
Okay.
It's a small school.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well,
but
what's your favorite time in history to teach?
Ooh, here we go. I thought, you know, I'd have an hour before I had to answer this one. Let's see. I really don't know. I feel like it's like picking a favorite child, you know? I
have such a zeal for history, and I feel like each period of time, no matter how you know, important or unimportant we may feel it is, in its own time, you know, okay, 1800s.
The whole thing?
Mm-hmm. You want more specific than a 100-year chunk of time in the grand scheme of history?
You didn't mention a part of the world or a major event.
Oh, boy. Well, I didn't know that was on the table, so... Oh, fuck. I feel like England in general, I feel like England has the richest history to some degree, right? Because the monarchies and so, yeah. Yeah.
It's fun.
England, and we'll move on.
Great. Yeah, I remember in history class, I loved Revolutionary War stuff.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah, I grew up in New England, so like the history was right there in front of us.
Mm-hmm.
So I cared more about it.
Oh, that's great, yeah. You know, I'm kind of a... Kind of a fun teacher, so.
Do fun teachers announce themselves as fun teachers?
Not to the class.
Or do they hop on desks and lean back?
Well, that's in the movies, yeah. But what I'll do is when I teach the Revolutionary War, I'll bring in an album by the band War, you know, Lowrider.
Mm-hmm.
I'll put out a record, I'll put it on a turntable, and I'll let it spin for a little bit.
And do you lean back and wait for their reaction?
I pretty immediately say Revolutionary War.
That's fun.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Could you pour my wine into my mouth?
Yeah, of course.
Thank
what
you.
What do you do? What's your occupation?
Well, right now, nothing. But usually I try to be a writer. You know what? Okay, great.
Usually you try and be a writer?
I would do writer in air quotes, but...
What are you working on? I mean, besides the next great American novel, what are you... Do you have a story? Do you have something in mind?
I got something brewing in my head.
Yeah, deep dish. What do you got?
I don't want to call it a mystery because it's not mystery, and I don't want to call it erotica because it's not erotica. But
so it's mystery meets erotica.
Sure, but it's more than both.
Yeah, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts.
Yeah. Sometimes it's mystery. Sometimes the mystery is erotic.
Okay, so is it like, the mystery itself is erotic in terms of it's a salacious crime? Okay.
Pretty sexy.
Great, like someone pinching butts.
Yeah, just sort of, yeah.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, a very sexy thing to do. Oh man, wow. I fan myself, but again.
Who are your mystery, I assume, Christy?
Oh yes, of course.
Yeah.
Murder on the Orient Express is a great one.
Yeah.
So good.
Yeah.
So good.
Poirot is the, I mean, fuck Sherlock Holmes, Poirot is where it's at.
Should we fuck Sherlock Holmes?
No.
I like Sherlock Holmes too.
Oh yeah, right? Oh, and have you seen the new series, the BBC series?
So good. My most popular sex dream, Sherlock Holmes.
When you say most popular.
If I could record it and watch it when I'm awake, I would.
Okay.
I would.
I've never heard somebody use that that term. They might say my favorite dream, but to say like my most popular makes it sound like there's a audience for it.
I wish there was. I mean, I wake up and tell my roommate about it.
Oh, you have roommates?
Yeah.
Roommate. What's his or her name?
Her name's Amy. She's quiet.
Mm-hmm.
She's fine. You won't fall in love with her. She's great. Perfect. You won't fall in love with her.
Okay.
We attract very different men.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What's her type?
Like strong, tall, handsome. handsome, interesting, worldly. Oh, it's a tooth. Leave it in. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Couldn't help but notice you said that she likes strong, handsome men. Mm-hmm. The two of you like opposite types.
I get it. You wear bow ties.
I literally get it. I get people saying, you have a memorable face or you look interesting. I get that all
you're
the time.
You're handsome.
Yeah, in the classic sense.
Yes,
not movie star classic in terms of like, oh,
not like
what a handsome dog.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Like you don't have shiny shoes, but you're still sweet. That kind of handsome.
Okay.
You know when you see a man,
you are
a
writer.
Got shiny.
You are a writer. You know how to spin a yarn.
Yeah.
You know how to spin a yarn.
Are you ready to order?
I think so. Yeah, we're good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Full disclosure, I just got fired. but my last table. What did you say? You wanted the pasta?
We didn't say it. Should we be...
No, I'll be back with that beer you asked for.
I didn't ask for a
Excellent.
Beer. Should we be charging you?
Should we ask for a different
She's
way
having a rough day.
Yeah. I mean, I want you to be comfortable. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Should I ask for another waitress? Or should we just give her, like, a big tip?
Let's see how this plays out.
Okay. All right.
That's what authors do.
Yeah. Will you...
You mine from real life. This is a story.
Are you going to put me in one of your books?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm honored. Tell me about the plot of your book. Go into it.
Like I said, it's part mystery, part erotica. So, chapter one. Jackson Hole, Wyoming. A cattle rancher sits around a fire close to midnight. That's all I have.
Well, talk it out with me now. I'm a good listener.
Well, I know I want there to be mystery, and I know eventually the cattle rancher will fornicate.
What if he sees a murder or hears a murder?
Bingo. Bingo bango. He hears a murder. So he's sitting around the campfire in Jackson Hole, Wyoming. It's very important that that's our setting. Do you understand? Do you understand?
I get it, yeah. I'm with you.
Just give me a yes.
Yes.
I prefer succinct answers.
Yes, I get it. I'm with you.
So he hears a murder. He doesn't investigate because he's close to a fire. Why would you leave a fire? So what he does is he closes his eyes to strengthen his other senses. As soon as his eyes are closed for 30 seconds, everything else is attuned to nature. He can hear the birds. He can hear the cattle breathe in the pens. He can hear the stars twinkle.
You weren't this sexual before.
But it's what he doesn't hear that disturbs him. He doesn't hear someone breathing. They're dead. There's been a murder.
I think they're on their first date, honey. Look at them over there. That's got first date all over.
You think that's the first date?
Yeah.
What makes you think first date?
Their body language. Looks like they haven't kissed before.
Well, she looks sleepy or something. Right?
little blood coming out of her nose. Yeah. Why isn't he saying something?
I don't know. Too polite, maybe? Too polite. Yeah, probably. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, what do you think people think we are?
Oh, I don't know. A year?
Really?
Maybe.
That's
we're
so
comfortable.
I know, but I think that's really sweet.
We're so comfortable together. You wear a shirt and I wear a sweater. Censoring herself? Was she being a robot? When she said beep, was that in lieu of a curse word? Or was that like she was some sort of animatronic?
It's the first one. Oh man.
Excuse me, I don't mean to snap. I don't make a habit out of it. Damn. Look at you on your dancing ass.
What?
You're dancing.
Yeah.
You're shitting up a storm.
So here's your check.
Is it taped to your hand?
Yes.
Thank you.
What can I do for you?
Like to pledge your entrees.
Do you already? Am I getting tables mixed up again?
I don't know, to be honest. Tell by her inflection that there's like there's something missing, right? It wasn't like
and
a.
And then
you know,
they fuck.
At some point, a beat. At some point, there was a bit of a robotic movement, but it was more of like mad libs, like omitting a word.
Blah, 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 you know? Blah, 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 blah.
But that's fine, you know? I guess we'll pay this and then give another car. Comfortable together. Comfortable. Together.
What about
you
that couple of
wear minutes? Wear a shirt.
I bet a week. So worried about my wife coming in here.
It's not gonna happen, Roger. It's gonna be fine.
Wake up, Roger.
It's gonna
wake
be
up,
fine.
Roger. Oh, you look beautiful. Oh, come on.
Take off the ring.
It hurts.
Then take it off.
It hurts.
All the more reason to take it off, Roger.
It hurts to take it off.
You know why it hurts? Because lying makes your fingers fat. Take it off. You make me look like a fool. You're a fucking coward. Roger, you're a fucking coward.
Oh, that was soft.
Yes. Yeah. That was my Bernays. That was my Bernays, and now you're wearing it. And every time you smell that Bernays in your three-piece suit, you think of me.
Oh, jeez.
And when your wife asks you what happened,
I got two glasses of champagne. Be careful drinking this.
Yes. What's the best 70s metal prog rock? Yes.
Just now.
Did I got fired?
Yeah.
It's my last day.
Did you just deliver an engagement ring to the wrong table? That's why you got fired to begin with.
You got me right, I did.
Why?
Misery loves company. To create chaos.
Have you looked up there? Have you seen what that table's doing right now?
It's not great.
Well, take another look.
It's gotten worse. He swallowed the ring to hide it, and she's giving him the Heimlich. What do you want me to do? I'm already fired. What are you going to do? Double fire me? Hire me back just to fire me? What are you going to do? Huh? Nothing. Sits back down by the fire, and then he hears another murder.
What? Who was it? Who was it?
The cops. The cops were murdered.
But who murdered them?
The cows.
Oh.
No?
I don't
Why
know.
Did you talk this through with me if you don't like it?
If I read 800 pages of a book and it was cows who murdered.
But isn't that erotic? Don't you think? A little too erotic? Yeah, I really do. You like Alanis? Shut up.
I wasn't talking. It's like rain on your wedding day.
It's a good advice.